Today, I'm going to show you how to easily edit an STL file in Meshmixer. Then we're going to add text using our slicer. So let's get cracking. This project starts at Thingiverse. If you haven't signed up for it, it is pretty awesome. The user that reached out to me was asking about a football and how to get rid of the name that was on it because they wanted to add their own custom one. So I did a search, and after a bunch of pages, I found this one, and if you've followed me at all, you know that this is not acceptable in my world. First, I went down and made sure it's Creative Commons. That way we have permission to adjust it. Then I'm going to go to the files, and I just want to download the single file. I don't want the zipped file. It just makes my life a little better and faster if I download it like that. Now, we're going to use a tool called Meshmixer. If you've never seen it before, I'll put a link up in the corner that shows you how to find it. It is not supported anymore, but I do still find it fantastic. I'm going to choose import, and we're going to just grab that football. Now, as I said, I cannot have either this logo or these words on it. All right, so to get rid of that, the tool we're going to use is the select tool. I'm going to use the sphere brush. This is a pretty large project, so you can see size 50 fits pretty well. I want to allow back faces. I'm going to leave geodistic distance on. Now when I just grab this area, I'm making sure I don't grab any of the parts too far away, but I'm getting all of those selected. You do want to check from every angle and make sure you haven't missed any like I had there. Once you've got it all selected, oops, there's another one I missed. All you have to do, my friends, is hit the letter F to erase and fill. How cool is that? I'm going to click accept. Notice it trimmed off those little pieces that were floating. Let's move over to this side and see if we can get rid of this nasty G as well. Once again, just selecting. I'm going to go all the way across. Let's get underneath there. Get that middle groove. Once again, let's hit F to erase and fill. Now this one could not be handled. We're going to simply click on the edit tool, and we want the plane cut tool. The plane cut right now is cutting this way, but we want it cutting vertically. So we're just going to rotate this 90 degrees. Notice if you come out into this grid, they snap to the spot you want. It is not lined up, and this blue line allows us to move it, but notice it goes 10 chunks at a time. That's not perfect, but watch this. If we hit the S, it shuts off the snap, and now you can adjust it to the exact middle. So I'm just zooming in so I can find that exact middle. I think it is right there. That looks pretty fantastic to me. And if we hit accept, bang, we have now got our project cut exactly in half. All right, so that's looking groovy, but we need two of them. We're going to do that by enabling the object browser. Could just do Control Shift O. Now we're going to click on it and we're going to make a duplicate. Notice we can see the two here. We're going to mess with the copy. We're going to go to the transform menu. Now we just want to take this and put it on the other side. Check this out. This is the measurement of Z, 29.992. We're going to simply go over here to translate and type negative 29.992. I'm going to delete that extra zero and press enter. Bang, the part is moved. Now we simply need to go to Y and rotate it 180 degrees. How cool is that? I'm gonna hit accept. Now let's quickly do some analysis of this. I'm gonna really quickly click on the inspector. It finds little parts that are errors, and I'm gonna let it auto repair them. Once that's complete, I'm gonna click done. All right, as we wrap this up, let's turn it into a single piece. Once again, Control A to grab it all. We're going to do convert to, and I want to make it a solid part. I'm going to create a new object and tell it accept. Bang! There is our solid football. And friends, now let's go add some text with our slicer. I'm going to click File, Export. I'm going to choose the binary STL format. I'm going to put it in my 3D modeling folder, and I'm going to call it football 25 and press enter. Of course, now I'm going to bounce to Bambu Lab Studio. We're going to create a brand new project, and let's add that file. Once again, it's in my 3D modeling folder, football 25. When it comes in, let's look down below. As you can see, the stand is there and there is no text, which absolutely makes my day. I'm gonna switch the entire design to be using blue. All right, I am always trying to print things quick, so let's click on this and I'm gonna scale it down. Right now it was about 10 centimeters. I'm gonna cut it down to 6 by typing 60. Of course, I promised you we would add text to it. I'm gonna do that by just bringing the text out. I'm gonna put my text on the outside, which is fun because I'm gonna change the color. I'm gonna set this to 1 millimeter of text. Notice this will take a little bit longer as it makes it, because it'll have to swap colors all the way through there on that top part. Of course, since it's for the lions, I don't really care about the extra time. I think it's gonna be pretty fun. You can look through all your fonts to find the one that you like. I'm gonna use this right here. And of course, I'm gonna put the word One Pride. This is where I absolutely love that it wraps around. I'll change that color in just a moment. Notice you can also change the size of the text with the plus and the minus. I'm gonna make it so that that color prints with the sweet silver that I've got from Zero. It is a silver gray silk. All right, so we've got our fun words. Friends, I also wanna paint the laces. Check this out. We're gonna turn on the paint tool. We're gonna switch to our cool silver gray from Zero. And then if we switch this to edge detection, we can easily click on all of these and just paint them. It just takes a few clicks and we've all of a sudden got cool colors. I do also want to highlight that if you're back here on the football shape, you can right click and you can add an SVG, so you could put a logo. I'm not going to do that today because I'm looking to print this a little bit quicker. Right now with it all designed the way I want, I'm going to hit slice plate. Notice it's going to take 2 hours and 26 minutes. I'm going to back up and make that just a little bit faster. Once again, with the whole project selected, I'm going to click scale, and where this was 60, I'm going to change it to 30 and press enter. Bingo, it is tiny. Slice plate down to 1 hour and 12 and print plate. And finally, send it to the 3D printer. And a little more than 1 hour later, we have got a tiny One Pride football. So there you have it, friends. Simple steps to take STL files, whether they're flat or curved, and modify them to add the parts you want. Now, of course, if you want to learn more about Meshmixer, I do have my playlist that I have put in the cards. And if you're interested in using the SVG of your logos, I have also got tutorials for those using Inkscape and also Pixlr. There's so many ways you can mess with things to make them do what you want. I do want to quickly say thank you to Ring of Fire for the original project on Thingiverse, and of course Dave for the question in my comments. I do want to quickly say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Don't forget there are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. Also, a huge shout out to everybody that's part of my Patreon group. Love how that group is growing. We are past 225 members. It has a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions and gain skills. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.